Hello friends, you will be thinking that in construction videos, why I have chosen the topic of glass for my video. Just imagine your home without glass. There are many types of glasses available in the market. Have you ever thought that what type of glass we use in windows, partitions, railings, doors, facade? There are different types of glasses with different appearance and properties are available, which can be used in various applications. Glass is one of the most widely used material in the architectural industry. Glass plays a pivotal role in controlling heat and flow of light in and out of the house. Glass was discovered 4000 years ago. The main material in glass is silica, means sand, which is more than 70% in composition as compared to other materials. We are going to discuss all the things related to glass in this video, like manufacturing process of glass, properties of glass, types of glasses used in construction industry, etc. Now let us see how the glass is manufactured. The glass manufacturing process was invented by Sir Alistair Pilkington in 1952 and is the most popular and widely used process in manufacturing architectural glass in the world today. There are 6 stages in this process. Stage 1, melting and refining. The raw materials like silica sand, sodium oxide, calcium oxide, dolomite, feldspar are mixed to make a batch and heated in a furnace at 1500 degrees Celsius. For getting different colors of glasses, certain metal oxides are added in the mixture. Following is the chart of metal oxides that can be used to get different colors of glasses. Stage 2, float bath. Glass from the furnace gently flows over the refractory spout on the mirror-like surface of molten tin, starting at 1100 degrees Celsius and leaving the float bath as solid ribbon at 600 degrees Celsius. In this process, a desired thickness of glass is achieved. Stage 3, coating. Multiple coatings can be deposited in the few seconds available as the glass flows beneath the coater. Stage 4, annealing. In this process, the glass is cooled slowly and internal stresses are removed to make the glass more prone to cutting. The way in which the glass is cooled determines its strength. If it is cooled over an extremely short duration of time, the glass can become too brittle to handle. Stage 5, inspection. Inspection technology now allows 100 million inspections per second to be made across the ribbon. Stage 6, cutting. In this process, a program is given to the computer and glass is cut to a required size. Properties of glass. Transparency. The transparency of glass can be from both sides or from one side only. In one side transparency, glass behaves like mirror from the other side. Strength. Glass is a brittle material, but by adding admixtures and laminates, we can make it as more strong. Workability. Glass can be molded into any shape or it can be blown during melting. Transmittance. The visible fraction of light that passing through glass is the property of visible transmittance. U-value. U-value represents the amount of heat transferred through glass. If a glass is said to be insulated unit, then it should have a lower U-value. Recycle property. Any glass can be 100% recyclable. There are different types of glasses used in construction for different purposes, depending on the property of glass. So let us see the types of glasses used in construction industry. Number 1. Clear glass, which is also known as normal glass or float glass or annealed glass or flat glass or soda lime glass. It is clear and transparent annealed glass. Clear glass usually has a natural greenish color. It is used in doors, windows, solar applications, shelves, etc. Number 2. Extra clear glass. Extra clear glass is a high quality glass which is free from impurities such as iron. It is used for making tabletops in the showroom of jewelry items, watches, crystalware items, fine fabrics and artware items, etc. for a sparkling display. Number 3. Tinted glass. The body tinted glass is float glass in which metal oxides are added for tinting. This type of glass saves energy, reduces heat penetration into buildings and gives a striking visual effect. Ideal for places with extreme heat conditions, this glass is available in several colors like grey, black, blue, bronze, etc. Tinted glass is an important architectural element for the exterior appearance of facades. Number 4. Low E glass. Low emissivity glass, commonly known as low E glass, has excellent thermal insulation properties. It allows only visible light to enter the room and thus gives protection from UV and infrared rays. In cold climates, they help in maintaining the temperature of interior and provide energy efficient solution. Number 5. Patterned glass or textured glass. It is a decorative and translucent glass with textures or patterns on one face of the glass for diffusing light and obstructing visibility from the outside. Patterned glass is useful for providing privacy to interiors of the house, thus extensively used in exterior windows and bathroom windows. Number 6. Wired glass. Wire mesh is inlaid in the glass to protect from shattering and breaking out under stress. Wire glass is low-cost fire-resistance glass. It is used to protect against the harmful effects of smoke and flame. We also use this type of wired glass in fire doors. Reflective glass or mirror glass. Reflective glass, also called mirror glass, imparts a mirror-like an appearance and wide palettes of colors to the exterior of buildings under daytime conditions. A coating of metal oxide is applied to one side of the clear or body-tinted glass in order to increase the amount of reflection by the glass. Reflective glass is used in office and high-rise building doors and windows for privacy. Number 8. Solar control glass. Solar control glass is a special oxide-coated glass which transfers less amount of heat in the building and also helps in reducing the glare of light entering. For tropical countries like India, this type of glass is very suitable as it helps in reducing the amount of air conditioning required. It is used in skyscrapers as glass facades in modern buildings, conservatory roofs, air-conditioned malls and showrooms, etc. Solar control low E glass. For facades which are in direct contact of sunlight, only low E glass cannot be used as they will trap the heat inside, leading to overheating of interiors. In such case, solar control low E glass is used, which blocks solar radiation as well as provides thermal insulation. An interesting example of its application is Burj Khalifa, where this glass is used to decrease the air conditioning cost. Laminated glass. It is also known as heatproof glass or soundproof glass or bulletproof glass or insulating glass or safety glass. Laminated glass is made by sandwiching a layer of polyvinyl butyl in between two or more layers of glass. This layer keeps the glasses bonded even when broken, and its high strength prevents the glass from breaking up into large shaped pieces. This produces a characteristic spiderweb cracking pattern when the impact is not enough to pierce the glass. Laminated glass is used in skylight glazing and automobile windshields. It is also used in exterior curtain walls and windows, balustrades, guardrails, etc. Number 11. Tempered glass or toughened glass. It is a strong glass which is heated to a uniform temperature and rapidly cooled to increase the strength. Toughened glass is 4 to 5 times stronger than annealed glass of equivalent thickness, hence it is used for strength and safety reasons. It will shatter into small cuboid fragments rather than sharp shards when broken, and therefore is less likely to cause injury. Tempered glass is used in commercial applications where wind, snow or thermal loads are more. It is used for escalator side panels, balustrades, staircase handrails and viewing partitions of sports complexes, resorts and airports, etc. Number 12. Heat strengthened glass. In case of heat strengthened glass, the cooling process is slower and hence its compression strength is lower. This type of glass is used for durability and safety reasons. Its mechanical strength is twice that of normal annealed glass and half of fully tempered glass. Heat strengthened glass is used for structural glazing as they safeguard against thermal breakages. Number 13. Insulated glass units. Insulated glass unit is a prefabricated unit made of two or more glass panels which are separated by cavities filled with dry air. They provide excellent thermal and sound insulation properties. Insulated glass units are used in office buildings, hospitals, hotels, houses and buildings with high heating or cooling requirements, and also buildings that need the temperature and humidity control, such as telephone exchanges, airport control towers and other environments that need regulated atmosphere and prevention of condensation. Number 14. Ceramic printed glass. Ceramic printed glass or ceramic freed glass is also known as silk screened glass for its appearance like silk screen. ceramic printed glass is used when it is important to mask a part or whole of glass for privacy or hiding the background. It is used for curtain walls, shower installations, glass doors, spandrels and partitions, stair rails, conference room, etc. Number 15. Lacquered glass. Lacquered glass, also known as back painted glass, is obtained by painting the back surface of the glass with high quality paint. Generally, they are always viewed from the front surface which is not painted. Back painted glass is extensively used in architectural spandrels, contemporary cupboards, furniture, kitchen countertops, backsplashes, washrooms of cinemas, hotels, restaurants, etc. Number 16. Frosted glass. Frosted glass has a translucent or obscure surface rather than transparent surface in float glass. One surface of the glass is etched and has a rough finish through which diffusion of light occurs. Frosted glass is used as a decorative glass where privacy is required, such as shower cubicles, conference rooms, office partitions, windows and doors of bedrooms, dressing rooms, etc. Number 17. Potash lime glass. It is also known as hard glass or Bohemian glass. Potash lime glass is similar to soda lime glass, except that soda is replaced by potash. It is used for making laboratory apparatus and combustion tubes. Number 18. Potash lead glass. It is also known as flint glass or lead glass. It is obtained from the fusion of mixture of silica, lead and potash. Lead glass is used for high quality glassware, cut glass, bulbs, lenses and prisms. Number 19. Borosilicate glass. Borosilicate glass is also known as Pyrex glass. It is obtained from the fusion of silica, borax, lime and feldspar. Borosilicate glass is used for making laboratory equipment and cooking utensils since it can withstand high temperature. Number 20. Common glass. Common glass, also known as bottle glass. It is prepared from cheap raw materials like sodium silicate, calcium silicate. It may be green, brown or yellow in color. Common glass is mainly used in manufacture of household and medicine bottles. So friends, I hope I have covered all the information about the glass in this video. Like this video if you learned something and be sure to share it with someone who might benefit from it. If you have any suggestions, please give your comments. And for more such videos, just click subscribe to Engineering Motive and turn on the notification bell so that you won't miss the new video. Finally, thanks for watching.